Hello grade 9, welcome again to my math class. Let us continue with lesson number 2, simplifying expressions with rational exponents. This is the third video or part 3 ng ating lesson and it is about quotient of powers. So meron tayong tatlong concept ng quotient of powers. Let us start now. Let us go now to the last law of exponent. Apply natin sa rational exponent, which is the quotient of powers. So, meron tayong tatlong concept dito. Just like before, dun sa previous video natin. So, we have a to the m over a to the n is equal to a m minus n if m is greater than n. So, kapag ito daw, assuming na fraction yan, kapag greater than daw yung m sa n na fraction, ito gagamitin mo. Okay, sa numerator tayo magma-minus. Then, we have the second one. Ganun pa rin, a to the m over a to the n is equal to 1 over a raised to n minus m if m is less than n. So, napakahalaga na alamin mo kung sino ang greater dun sa fraction. Kasi, is either ito ang gagamitin mo or yung previous one. Yung pangatlo, a to the m over a to the n, ganun pa rin, but it is equal to 1 if m daw is equal to n. So, assume mo na fraction to na equal dito, therefore, makakancel mo lang siya, that is equal to 1. And also, integrate na natin siya sa zero exponent. So, kung i-apply mo to, kung halimbawa pareho silang fraction, equal sila, gamitin mo yung first concept ng quotient of power, magma-minus ka, magiging a raised to 0 siya. Therefore, any number raised to 0 is equal to 1. Okay? So, since magsusubtract tayo ng fraction dito, let us have the review on the subtraction of fraction. We have the similar fraction and then the dissimilar fraction. A over B daw minus C over B. Same denominator siya. Subtract mo lang yung numerator and then copy the denominator. Okay, and then reduce to lowest term if possible. Then, kung dissimilar naman siya, parang yung sa addition lang, a over b minus c over d, magkaiba ang denominator. So, a times d minus b times c, all over b times d. Okay, so sundan mo lang yung formula na yan para sa dissimilar fraction. Okay, so also, important din na malaman natin kung sino ang mas greater sa fraction. So, let us review on how to compare fraction. So, A over B is greater than C over D daw if yung product ng extremes, yung A tsaka D, is greater than the product of the means. So, also, A over B is less than C over D daw if the product of the extreme is less than the product of the means. AD is less than BC. So, malalaman mo na ngayon kung ano, kung sino ang greater sa fraction, and then you can decide kung ano dito sa tatlo na to ang iyong gagamitin. Okay, so let us have some examples. Okay, let us have now examples. Let's have example number 1. X raised to 5 halves over x raised to 1 half. Okay, so gusto natin makasiguro kung ano ang greater sa 5 halves and 1 half. Apply natin yung concept na ng comparing fraction. So we have 5 halves, compare natin sa 1 half. Okay, product of the extreme is 10, product of the means is 2. So 10 is greater than 2. So ang therefore, yung 5 halves is greater than 1 half. Sa numerator tayo magma-minus. Okay. So, 1 divided by 1 is 1. Hindi na natin susulat yun. So, we have now x raised to 5 halves minus 1 half. Okay. Similar fraction naman yung ma-minus natin. So, subtract to the numerator, we have 5 minus 1 is 4. And then, copy the denominator, the 2. Okay. 4 can be divided by 2. And that will be 2. No? So we have now the answer as x raised to 2 or x squared. Yan ang sagot natin sa number 1. Okay, so let us have example number 2. 36 m raised to 2/3 and then over 12 m raised to 1/2. Okay, so meron tayo dito ng numerical coefficient, 36 yung isa sa 12. 36 can be divided by 12 and that will be 3 na nasa numerator kasi 36 ang dinivide mo na nasa numerator. Ngayon, meron tayong same base dito, m. Yung isa 2/3, yung isa naka-raise sa 1/2. Compare natin siya para sigurado tayo. So, 2/3 compared to 1/2. So, product of the extreme is 4. Product of the means is 3. 4 is greater than 3. So, ganun din yung symbol dito. 2/3 is greater than 1/2. Okay? So, simplifying this, we have now 3. Sa numerator tayo mag-minus kasi greater yung 2/3 sa 1/2. So, m raised to 2/3 minus 1/2. So, dissimilar fraction to, apply natin yung concept na pinakita natin kanina. We have now 3m, yung AD minus BC over BD. So, m now will be raised to 2 times 2 minus 1 times the 3 all over BD, which is 3 and 2. Okay, simplifying more. We have now 3 times m raised to, this is 4, 2 times 2 is 4, minus 3 over 6. Okay, so furthermore, we have 3 times m, 4 minus 3 is 1, copy the denominator, the 6. We have 3m raised to 1/6 as our answer sa number, example number 2. Okay, so sana nakakasunod tayo. Let us have now example number 3. So let us have 8 raised to 7/3 over 8 raised to 1/3. This is very obvious na yung 7/3 is greater than 1/3. So sa numerator tayo magma-minus. So you want to make sure, so compare mo pa rin. So 7/3 is a 1/3. So, 7 times 3, product of the extreme will be 21, and this is 3, product of the means, 21 is greater than 3, therefore, 7/3 is greater than 1/3. Okay, so let's sub now 8, raised to 7/3, minus 1/3. Okay, similar fraction naman siya, this will become 8, 6 minus 1 will be, 7 minus 1 will be 6, over 3, copy the denominator. So 6 can be divided by 3 and that will be 2. So the result now will be 8 square. So parang yung example number 1 kanina. But 8 square can be simplified as 8 times 8 and that will be 64. So answer natin sa number 3 will be 64. Okay, so let us go to example number 4. Okay, sulat natin. Example number 4. 2 raised to 1 pip over 2 raised to 3/4. Okay, parang yung number 3 lang. Compare natin yung 1 pip sa 3/4 kung sino ang greater. So, 1 pip tsaka 3/4. 1 pip and then 3/4. Product of the extreme is 4. Product of the means is 15. Therefore, 4 is less than 15. 1 pip also is less than 3/4. Sa denominator tayo, magma-minus. Okay? So, we have now 1. Kasi may 1 tayo dito. And then, over 2 raised to 3/4. So, we have 2 raised to 3/4 minus 1 pip. Minus 1 pip. Ayan. Okay, so, dissimilar fraction. Apply uli natin yung concept kanina. So this will be 2 raised to 3 times 5 minus 1 times 4, extend natin, over 4 times 5. Okay, simplifying more, we have here 1 over 2, this is 15, 5 times 3 is 15, minus 4 over 20, 4 times 5 is 20. So finally, we have 1 over 2 raised to 11 over 20. So this is now our answer. Ayan. So number 4, 1 over 2 raised to 11 over 20. Okay, let's go now to example number 5. X raised to 1 pip times y over x raised to 3 pip times y raised to 1 half. Okay, may dalawa tayong variables dito, x and y, same base din to. Okay, so compare natin yung 1 pip sa 3 pip. Okay, obviously, 3 pip is greater than 1 pip. So, siguraduhin natin. 1 pip and then isa is 3 pip. Product of the extreme is 5. Product of the mean is 15. So, 5 is less than 15. So, ganun din yung symbol dun. Okay, so, sa denominator tayo magma-minus sa x. Then, we have here 1. 1 is greater than 1 half, obviously. So, exponent nito 1, di ba? Okay, so, pwede tayong isulat natin. Y raised to 1 minus 1 half. Over x 3 pip raised to 3 pip minus 1 pip. Okay, finally, we have the similar fraction to. So, y. So, 2 times 1 will be 2 minus 1 over 2. Okay, so parang 1 half. And then, yung x naman, similar fraction siya. Meron tayong 3 minus 1 will be 2 over 5. So, 2 pip. So, finally, sagot natin will be y raised to 1 half then over x raised to 2 pip. This is now our answer sa number 5. Okay, so sana nakakasunod kayo. Let us have the final example. So, this example is nakita ko sa ating module. So, i-correct lang natin kasi mayroong konting typographical error doon. So, let us have this. Okay, so x raised to negative 1 half. Tapos, meron tayong y squared. Tapos, quantity raised to negative 5 fourths over x squared times y raised to 1 half. Okay, so makikita nyo itong numerator, magpa-power of power muna tayo. Okay, then copy muna natin yung denominator. Okay, so this is the same as x raised to negative 1 half. Diba, multiply natin to sa power of power. This is negative. By the way, this is negative 1 half and this is negative 5 fourths. Tapos sa y, meron tayong 2 times negative 5 fourths uli. Then, copy muna natin yung denominator, x squared y raised to 1 half. Okay, so multiply natin yung fraction na to. This will be negative times negative will be positive 5 over 8. So, that will be x raised to 5 over 8. Okay, so and then the y, this can be simplified. 4 can be divided by 2 and that will be 2. So, negative 5 halves. So, y raised to negative 5 halves over x squared times y raised to 1/2. Okay, so obviously, yung 2 is greater than 5/8. So, dito tayo magma-minus. And then, we have 1/2. Positive yung 1/2 greater sa negative 5/8. So, dito tayo magma-minus. Okay, positive is always greater than negative number. Okay, so let us have now. So, may numerical coefficient tayo dito, 1. So, may iiwan yung 1 sa numerator. Over x. So, squared minus 5/8. Tapos yung y, 1/2 minus negative 5/2. Okay, simplifying more. We have 1, still 1, over the similar fraction niya, magiging 2 times 8 will be 16, minus, this is 1, 1 times 5 is 5, over 8. And then sa y naman, similar fraction siya, pero negative times negative will become positive. So, magiging addition na to. So, magiging 6 over 2. 6 over 2. Okay, finally, we have the answer now as 1 over x. 16 minus 5 is 11 over 8 times y. 6 divided by 2 is 3. Y cubed. So, the answer now will be 1 over x raised to 11/8 and times y cubed. And this is the answer for number 6. Okay, so sana may natutunan kayo. Next video natin, next lesson natin will be rational exponent. Kukonvert naman natin to radical expressions and vice versa. So, God bless everyone. Thank you for watching.